Thank you, everybody. Thank you. Yeah. Thank you, man. Thanks, everybody. Welcome to the show, brothers and sisters. I know you're waiting for only one man. Yeah, desire. And the man is Johan Nilsson in the house. Yeah. Thank you, everybody.
Thank you very much. All right, settle down, settle down, settle down. Thank you. How you feeling? How you doing? You feeling great? I must say something. First of all, welcome to this New Year's Eve J-Vlogg vlog edition. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. It's soon going to be New Year's Eve. And it's going to be 2019, all right? So I must say, first of all, that's great, you know what I'm saying? And I just want to say something right now, that you are the greatest stand-up audience that I have ever had, you know what I'm saying? But on the other hand, you're the only stand-up comedy audience I've ever had, you know what I'm saying? First, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, yeah. So check this out, right? What happened yesterday, it was real strange. It was real weird, all right? I had a woman here who's banging on my door for like 20 minutes, all right? But I wouldn't let her out. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? Yeah, 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 I wouldn't let it out, right? Alright, yeah, yeah. Listen, I have an eating problem, right? I must admit that. And my eating problem is that I don't have anything to eat. I don't have anything to eat, you know? But I gotta say, yesterday I was at this club, right? And what happened was everyone looked at me and started to laugh. And I don't know why. Why were they laughing? Because the only thing I did was this. That was it, right? That was all. That was all. I don't understand why they were laughing, right? Listen, listen. And also, you know what happened yesterday, right? It's so cold outside. And it's so icy on the ground, right? So what happened was, it was so icy. I started to think about this white rapper from the early 90s. Right? You know, that's not the joke. The joke is here. It was so ice on the ground, I fell on the ground, you know what I'm saying? And when I fell, everyone on the street started to laugh, right? And I can just show you, this is how it looked like, right? I was just walking down the street, right? I just walking like this, you know? And I just... It was like, I just fell, man. I just fell. I just fell to the ground. You believe that stuff, man? I just fell. This edition of J-Vlogg, this is like Number four, right? This is number four, J-Vlogg 4. And guess what? We're gonna have a New Year's Eve rap song. That's right. A New Year's Eve rap song. And it's gonna come to you later. First, let me get down to my studio. And we'll continue this show, this J-Vlogg vlog. You know what I'm saying? Welcome. Thank you. Thank you.
Didn't I say I wasn't ready for romance? Didn't we promise we would only be friends? And so we danced, though it was only a slow dance. I started breaking my promises right there and then. Didn't I swear there would be no complications? Didn't you want someone who's seen it all before? Now that you're here, it's not the same situation. Suddenly I don't remember the rules anymore. This night is mine. It's only you and I. Tomorrow, such a long time away, this night can last forever.
Welcome back, y'all. Welcome back. We are here again in Sundbyberg in Sweden. And this is vlog number four. We did it. Fourth time. Here we are. And my vlog has been a universal sensation. I can't believe to describe this. I mean, it's like unbelievable. I'm having a hard time believing this myself. But I've been getting so many good comments and so many compliments from people all over this world. It's just amazing to me, you know what I'm saying? And I'm happy, you know? I mean, you talk about the talk of the town. This has been the talk of the world. You know what I'm saying? It's like unbelievable. I'm almost like a household name, not just in my own house, but in every house, in every building, in every street and valley, all around the world. Soon, you know what I'm saying? Because it's only going up. That's right. I'm only going up. I'm getting more and more famous for every vlog. And soon everyone knows my name. Everywhere. Because they think I'm good. And they want to watch me. And just to prove it, I've been getting a lot of comments and some unbelievable, compliments. It's out of this world. Let me just show you a couple of them. We have on my YouTube channel, which is like a bomb. It has exploded on YouTube everywhere. We can see a YouTube member who is called Mellow Out Vlogs It Out. A very good name. And that member says, "Dope, bro," with a big fire next to the words. And that was for my vlog 2. And then, as far as my vlog 3 is concerned, well, when I read all the comments about vlog 3 on my Facebook page, I had to pull out my umbrella to read all of it. Why, you may ask me? Because it was just raining with comments about how good that was. And if we look at some of the comments right here, I mean, some of the, they said like, "Hell yeah, my brother, you on fire. And man, I love this beat." And we have one person said, "A new rap star is born. And keep on doing what you're doing," and all of that. And this is just unbelievable. I'm so happy for this. And that's what I will do. I will continue, you know what I'm saying, on this path to glory. And tomorrow, it is Christmas Eve, which means that we have had a Christmas spirit for the last month or so. And to get into the spirit of it, I can tell you that exactly a week ago, I saw a Christmas concert with my mother and right here in Stockholm. And we saw, in my opinion, Sweden's best male vocalist of all time. He's not so well known in the United States, but he's pretty well known in Europe. And of course, he's a living legend in Sweden. He's 70 years old right now. His name is Tommy Körberg. And believe me or not, this is the sixth time that I have seen him live, which is a record. I haven't seen any other artist that many times. I've seen Lionel Richie a lot of times and Al Jarreau, but Tommy Körberg has the record. And it's the third concert with a Christmas theme, all right, with him. So that was great. Of course, vocally, Tommy Körberg was in his prime at his best in the 80s and 90s. All right, he's 70 years old right now, so of course he doesn't sing as great as he did back in the day, but still, he's a pretty damn good singer, and he sings great, and comparing to all other 70-year-old singers worldwide, I would say he's still one of the best in the world, I would say. But it was great, and well, hopefully I will see him some more time. But just to show you, if you haven't heard him, just check out this little small clip from his peak. Listen. Now that's a voice, ladies and gentlemen, that can move mountains, all right? But, as I said earlier, it's not only Christmas Eve tomorrow. You all know what's going to happen in 1 week and a day, in 8 days, to be exact. That's right, it's New Year's Eve, and that's why I've dressed up already. And what I'm going to do right now is something that I know that you want me to do. And I will do it just for y'all because I'm an all-around entertainer. All right. In this vlog, I've done stand-up comedy and I've done singing. And now I'm going to do rapping. All right. Listen, the most asked question that I have gotten from fans and people and friends is it really freestyle rap that you do? Is it really spontaneous? Or have you written it down in advance? So, what I'm gonna do from now on is I'm gonna drop the freestyle tag along my rap videos just so that it will be a mystery if it is freestyle or not. It's up to you to decide for yourself. It would be a mystery. It would be something that people will talk about, like the Loch Ness animal or Bigfoot. Do they really exist or not? Did they exist? It's the same thing here. Does J-Vlogg do freestyle rap or not? It's up to you to decide. But I can tell you one thing. Every word and every lie that I deliver comes from here and here. I've written it myself. Which is not so hard to figure out, since most of it is about my own life. So what I'm gonna do right now is I'm gonna rap, and the theme of the song is New Year's Eve. And the song will be called and is named 2019 All Over the World. That's the name of the song. And I believe and I hope that this will be like the big theme around New Year's Eve. It will be like a New Year's theme, not just this year, but perhaps in years from now on, in the future. You know what I'm saying? That's my aspiration, because it's a great song. It will make you feel good. It will make you want to party and have a good time. And, well, I'm happy with it. And it's called 2019 All Over the World. It's written by myself. The words. And, well, let's just get into it, shall we? Let's do it.
Tonight, you and Nilsson from Sullivan invites you to New Year's Eve party. It will be 2019.
Oh, yeah. Where you gonna be?
It's 2019 all over the world. And I miss the Jerry Curls.
Here we go, y'all. Hello, hello. I know you're a fan of Johan, Nilsson, and I'm here again. It's New Year's Eve, and you're invited. And like the Pointer Sisters, I'm excited. This year, we'll go out with a bang. And I'm even cooler than Cool and the Gang. I was born in 1975, and still, I don't have a license to drive. But I'm very smart, because I started to think that if I drive a car, then I can't have a drink. And even on New Year's Eve, I don't smoke. And that's no joke.
Johan Nilsson is my name. And that is my game. It's 2019 all over the world. And I miss the Jerry Curls.
Here we go. The New Year party will be a ball. I wish I could spend it with Arsenio Hall. When I'm in Sumibai, I have no foes. Everyone points at me and says, there he goes. When I go up, I put women in a trance. They all beg me, please, can we just dance? Finding time for women can be problematic, cause they all think I'm so charismatic. And the only thing that can stop me from getting laid is if the police will bust the door open and make a raid. And my man Mumps is not from Zambia, he's from Gambia.
Johan Nilsson is my name, and that is my game. It's 2019 all over the world, and I miss the Jerry Curls.
Here we go, y'all. If I ever would meet Melanie B, I would ask her, will you marry me? She's so hot, she doesn't need pearls. She's clearly my favorite among the Spice Girls. I used to be in love with Caio Ciccone. If I make her dinner, it will be macaroni. And don't forget while I'm kicking my bars, a little peace out to Bruno Mars.
It's 2019, 2019. It's 2019, 2019. 2019, it's 2019.
I wish you all a happy new year.
Johan Nilsson is my name, and that
Happy New Year!